back up. And now we're going to bring ourselves down onto the floor, working our chest and our shoulders. This is a two for one. Extend the right arm, take the left leg, bend the knee and place the foot flat. You're going to hold the left hand on the floor. You'll see from the opposite view and try to open up that leg as much as possible, breathing in. Let us release that side. Extend the other arm. And now you can see how it looks from this direction. Breathing in deeply. Bring it back. And then back into all fours. Here we're going to come into camel pose. Let's go ahead and now. You have two options. You can fully go into it with no problem. Hold on to the heels. Breathe into it and hold it for 8 counts. Goal is to thrust the pelvis forward. For beginners, do 4 at a time. Start with your left hand on the heel and then the right arm up into the ceiling, thrusting the pelvis forward. And you hold this for again, 4 on each side. Coming back up and then altering your hand to the other heel and this one fully extending, breathing deeply. And then inhale back. Once you've done your 4 counts, come right back into a child pose, decompressing your back once again. Ground the heels right into the glute into the heels and feel the stretch as you walk your hands away. Flow now. Lift the heels, breathe. Let's come in a plank. Let's press up dog. Exhale. Drop the knees. Sink into cobra. Breathe in. Exhale. Down dog. Knees, inhale up, again alternate, inhale up, inhale up, exhale, cobra, up dog, down dog, plank it, press, up dog, press, and drop into child pose. Back, and now I'm going to have you go to the side. Bend at the knee, pull away the heel. Exhale. Up dog, drop the knee. Release it, square yourself out, down dog, up dog, and let's go back into child pose. I'm going to ask you now to come onto your back. You can use a pillow also, but if you have a block, and I would suggest two. There's two ways of doing this. We're going to now move ourselves into a position of taking the bigger block, the thicker one, mid to lower back, mid back, basically where the floating ribs are. and you're going to recline back. Now, take the other block, it could be the same size if you want, and you're going to place it on the head. This allows us to open up the shoulders and chest while supporting the back on that block. Beautiful support, nice restorative pose. Bring the soles of your feet together if you wish to open up and work a little bit more on the hips, or you can just slowly extend the leg, your choice, palms facing up. And just focus on breathing. If there's tension in the shoulders, allow yourself to lengthen the neck so there's space along the cervical spine. As you breathe, exhale, sink those shoulders between your gauges of your block right here, so that way your shoulders kind of drop into the earth. And breathe. Let's do about 8 of these breaths. Keep yourself completely focusing just on the breath and being empty. There's no judgment, no thoughts. Just stay here and now. Time to turn the brain off, to turn yourself into just being in this moment. Take the block again to the side and gently cross your legs one more time. This time, fold forward, hold the pose, drop, roll back up, take the hands on the knees, and let's round. Inhale. Exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, last one, and breathe. Go in a circle, extend the chest, concave it back, do this 4 more times, 3, 2, and 1. Reverse it. Three, 2, and 1. Let us now allow ourselves to come, lie down, and get prepared for your meditation. Your priming, if you've already done it, go for it. If you haven't, I always suggest start it first so it can get you invigorated. So this is a beautiful class for you to get yourself warmed up, opening the chest and back. Until our next class tomorrow, Namaste.